them are capsicum. The Dutch mention kai, or Dutch mention kai, we call it as capsicum fruticans. And capsicum annuum is the chilies. Okay, so the Solanaceae family is commonly called as potato family. It includes the example like potato, brinjal, tomato, chilies, capsicum. Then it also includes tobacco plant, Nicotiana tobacum. It is where the leaves are used for various purposes, as chewing leaves or as for smoking purpose. They use this as tobacco that is obtained from these leaves of the Nicotiana tobacum plant. So these are all some of the Solanaceae plants. Even petunia, they are grown as ornamental plants. It belongs to Solanaceae. Datura plant, which grows widely, I told you about that. That also belongs to Solanaceae. So let us discuss about this Solanaceae plant. Okay, so the it is largely a potato family. Its distribution, you find them in tropical regions, subtropical region, and even temperate zones. You find this distribution of the Solanum family, Solanaceae family. So the if you look into the plants, what are the type of plants? Some of them are herbs, some of them are shrubs. Small trees are also noticed, especially Datura. Small tree, you can notice them. There is one plant which is also a creeper, Solanum c40anum. So they have not given it here. So there is a climber also here in case of Solanaceae, but only one plant is there. The stem is, in case of Solanaceae or potato family, the stem is herbaceous. In case of herbs, it would be herbaceous, rarely woody. Okay, and it is aerial, it is erect. The stem is erect, it is not spreading in the ground, it is erect, vertically erect. So cylindrical, if you look into the stem, they are cylindrical. Some of them would be quadrangular, but in case of Solanaceae, they are cylindrical stem. They are branched, and if you break the stem and see, they are solid, that is completely filled, or sometimes the cavity might be there, hollow. And you find the stem will be hairy or glabrous, and underground modified stems are there in case of potato. You can notice this tuber. Okay, the scientific name of potato is Solanum tuberosum. Okay, they have a tuber underground to them. They have this tuber, so you should remember about that. Why do we call it as underground stem? They are storing food there. So how do we come to a conclusion that it's a stem? They have this nodes from which the buds arises, the axillary buds arises. So there is nodes and internodes. The node region, we call it as eye of the potato. So remember about that aspect of it. The leaves, they are alternate. In case of Solanaceae, they are alternate. They can be simple leaf, rarely pinnately compound. So most of them are alternate leaves. They are simple leaves and rarely pinnately compound. Okay, so that is one aspect that you have to remember about. Then they are reticulate venation root. Also, you can remember they have taproot system because they are dicotyledonous plants. Okay, so reticulate venation in leaf you can notice as typical to any dicot plant. Now we'll discuss the floral characters. See, the inflorescence is solitary. Solitary means floral. You can notice a single flower will be there, but how can you call it as an inflorescence? Is there is a boundary between the peduncle and the pedicel. So there is a boundary between the peduncle and pedicel. So you can notice in the stalk. So we call it a solitary sign. So solitary flower. They are axillary. The inflorescence can be found at the axils, or they might be cymose inflorescence, as in case of Solanum. Cymose inflorescence is where they have this basipetal succession of flowers. So the older flowers are found at the apex and younger flowers are found at the base. So we call it as basipetal succession of flowers. In cymose inflorescence, the inflorescence axis is definite and you find the older flowers at the apex and younger flowers are at the base. So that we call it as basipetal succession of flowers. So inflorescence in case of Solanaceae, it is a solitary sign or axillary or cymose inflorescence, as you notice in case of solanum. Okay, the flowers are bisexual, that is, you find both male and female reproductive organ in the same flower. Andrecium and gynecium are present together. Okay, the actinomorphic flowers, you can divide this flower into two equal halves in any plane passing through the central axis. So we call it as actinomorphic flowers. They exhibit radial symmetry. So that is the reason we call it as actinomorphic flower. You can divide the flower into two equal halves in any plane of division passing through the center. So in any plane of division which passes through the central axis, you can divide the flower into two equal halves. So they are actinomorphic flowers. Calyx, if you count the number of sepals, they are five in number. So five sepals, and they are united. See, when they are united, gamosepalous condition, they are shown by this hooks, which indicates that they are united, persistent. They are present even after the fruit formation. A very good example for persistent calyx is the brinjal. What you find as a crown on top of brinjal is nothing but persistent calyx. Even in chilies, you can find this persistent calyx. Even in case of capsicum, that is Dapmenshinkai or Dodmenshinkai, whatever you call it as, you find that persistent calyx on them. And they exhibit, sepals are showing valvate aestivation. That is, they are neither overlapping nor overlapped. They are free. So if there is no overlapping nor overlapped condition, the sepals are all free. So we call that as valvate aestivation. So this is what you notice in case of calyx. Okay. Corolla, they have five petals. And again, they are united, and valvate aestivation, you can notice. So five petals, they are united, and valvate aestivation. Then they have this epipetalous condition, that is, stamens are attached to the calyx. So the sepals, petals, they have drawn, and they have given hook to indicate that they are all united. And you can notice that the stamens are attached to the petals. Epipetalous condition is shown by this filament being attached to this hooks. Can you see that five stamens? They have this filament attached to the hooks of this corolla, or the petals, which indicates epipetalous condition. So petals five, united, and valvate aestivation you notice here. So the other floral characters, andrecium. Stamens are five, epipetalous. So the epipetalous condition, you can see how they are shown in the particular flower. So here you have some members of Solanum nigrum. Solanum nigrum is a, you use it for making this sopsaru. They have small blackberries. So I've already shown in this biological classification, Solanum nigrum. Okay. So which is used as for making greens, I told you. So the flower of that, they have dissected and shown it, LS of flower. So the stamens, they are all fixed to the, the filaments are attached to the corolla. That is the one thing that you notice. They are all free. Okay, five stamens are there. And this is the gynecium with a superior ovary. And you have this long style and stigma. Okay, so stamens are five and epipetalous. Gynecium is bicarpellary. See, you can notice in this floral diagram, bicarpellary and syncarpus. These two carpels are fused. And they are bilocular also. Ovary is superior. You can notice here they have a superior ovary. A placenta is swollen. So what you notice in this condition is the placenta is swollen with many ovules. So this is nothing but axile placentation itself. Placenta is swollen with many ovules. You can see the brinjal fruit where they have many seeds in them. Tomato has many seeds in them. Okay, so placenta is swollen and they have many ovules. Fruit is berry or capsule. The technical name for the Solanum fruit is berry, or it can be capsule. In case of Datura, it is a capsule, and we call it a septifragral capsule. Anyway, you don't have it for your syllabus part of it, or else I would have discussed the types of capsule. The septifragral capsule you can notice in case of Datura plant. Okay, seeds are many and endospermous. So they have this endosperm within the seed. So seeds are many and they are endospermous. So that is what you notice in case of this Solanaceae. So the floral formula, we have that plus within circle indicates it is actinomorphic flower, bisexual, calyx 5, they are fused, that is gamosepalous, 5 within brackets, corolla, that is petals are fused, 5 within bracket, and the andrecium, they are 5 in numbers, and the stamens are attached to the corolla. So you draw this arrow mark from A to C, which indicates that they are epipetalous condition. Gynoecium, the ovary is superior, so you underline it. Below the G, you have this dash. So gynoecium is superior. They are bicarpellary syncarpals. They have two carpels and they are fused. So that fused condition, we put it within bracket. So bicarpellary syncarpals. So we have put that within bracket. And they are also bilocular. And they have this axile placentation. So the central axis is swollen. The placenta is swollen with many ovules. So you can remember about this. Fruit is berry or capsule, we call it as. Economically important plant, food, which we edible plants are brinjal, tomato, potato. So they are very, very much important. You can't imagine your life without potatoes, French fries, chips, isn't it? So the potato is very good staple food in many of the European countries. So they are a good source of carbohydrates, and potato is also not native to our country. Okay, so potato was infected with a fungi. It caused potato famine I was discussing about. So just remember about this important edible plants like tomato, brinjal, potato. Okay, spices, we have this chilies. Okay, chilies are there, which is the spices. So you also have this bhaji menshinkai, which is a little fleshier chili. Then the dap menshinkai or dot menshinkai, that is capsicum we call. Both of them are capsicum. This chili is also called as capsicum. Their generic name is capsicum, but species is annuus, capsicum annuum. Whereas the dap menshinkai, we call it as capsicum fruticans. Okay. Medicine is Belladonna ashwagandha, Vaitenia somnifera antkariti, ashwagandha plant, and Belladonna atropa, they are the medicinal plants. Atropine is obtained from this Belladonna. Okay, so the ashwagandha, we call it as Vaitenia somnifera. So these are the medicinal plants you have to remember. Common name, whatever name they have given in your book, you remember it. Belladonna, it is Atropa belladonna. Belladonna atropa, atropine is obtained from them. Ashwagandha is Vitania somnifera. Then fumigatory plants, which are used for smoking, the tobacco plant. Okay, fumigatory plants. Then ornamental plants, you can see the petunia, the colorful flowers. They are grown as shogira or ornamental plant. So the petunia, you can remember them as. That is about the family Solanaceae. Okay, so next family we are going to study, it belongs to the class Monocotyledonae, that is Liliaceae family. It is placed under the Monocotyledonous family class. So because they have single cotyledon, okay, so let us discuss about that Liliaceae family. So Liliaceae family, important, the most used vegetable is onion, Allium cepa. Okay. So if the rates of Allium cepa, if it increases, onion, so there is a huge impact on the people. And it has also led to change of governments because of the rates of onion. Okay, so that is the impact that it has on the society, especially Indians. We use a lot of onions in our food. Okay, we can't imagine dishes without utilizing onions, except for this Jain food or Sattvic food. Where they avoid onion and garlic, but majority of the others, they utilize this onion and garlic as an important source of vegetable as well as food. So the lily family, Liliaceae, is commonly called as lily family. So the examples are Allium cepa, that is onion. Allium sativum is garlic. They also come under this. Then the aloe vera is also placed under Liliaceae. You have various other plants like the most Agnipaksha, we call it as, if you look into this, Gloriosa superba. The flower is not only glorious, but it is also superb. So the scientific name itself is Gloriosa superba. It's an Ayurvedic medical plant, medicinal plant. They call it as Agnipaksha. Okay. Tulips are also lily. They belong to Liliaceae family. Aloe vera, for the cosmetical value it has, this aloe vera is also from Liliaceae family. Colchicum autumn nail. So we use this colchicine for arresting the cell division stages. So colchicum autumn nail is also obtained from this. Is also a member of this Liliaceae family. Asparagus. Okay, asparagus are also used as vegetables. Some of the asparagus, they are used as ornamentals to stuff the flower bouquets. They use this leaves of asparagus. So they are also used as vegetables, but we don't use asparagus much as vegetable. So these are some of the economically important plants, apart from onion and the garlic, which are also members of Liliaceae. They might not have mentioned in economic importance, but you should remember they are also members of Liliaceae. So let us understand about this lily family. It is representing the monocotyledonous plants. For your syllabus, you have only one monocotyledonous plant to study, that is Liliaceae. Okay. It is Liliaceae. I should be there. It is missing. Not Liliaceae. It is Liliaceae. So it is distributed worldwide. So the lily family is distributed worldwide. So some of the important families of the Liliaceae is distributed through, let us understand the vegetative characters. They are perennial herbs. Perennial herbs means they would be flowering throughout the year. So with underground bulbs, in case of onion, we call it as bulb. In some of them, we call it as corms, like asparagus, we call them as corms. Some of them have rhizomes. Okay. So the perennial herbs, that is throughout the year, they flower with underground bulbs. In case of onion, we call it as bulb. Even in case of garlic, it is a bulb. So they are found underground. So they are the bulbs that you notice, bulbs or corms, and rhizomes. In some of them, you can notice the rhizomes. So their leaves are mostly basal, alternate, linear, X-stipulate. That is, they don't have stipules, with parallel venation. But in case of onion, you can notice that they have three types of leaves. Scaly leaves. Within this bulb, you find the fleshy leaves, non-green fleshy leaves. And you find the cylindrical green leaves, which we call it as the spring onion or spring roll, what we call it as spring onion. So that is the green cylindrical hollow leaves that we have. Okay. So this sort of three types of leaves you can notice in case of onion. And leaves mostly basal, they are found at the base of it. They are alternate, linear, they are long, elongated, X-stipulate, they don't have stipules. And you can notice parallel venation. Obviously, since it belongs to Liliaceae, they have parallel venation. In case of Gloriosa superba, the leaf apex is modified as tendril. Very rarely you find leaf apex, leaf tudi idiyalla, that gets modified as tendril, which you notice in Gloriosa superba. Leaf apex modified as tendril. Okay. So the floral characters, when we come to it, inflorescence is solitary, that is, they are single, or you might find the cymose inflorescence, or umbellate clusters, just like umbrella, they would be arranged. So this we call it as umbellate clusters. So inflorescence can be solitary cyme or cymose inflorescence. And sometimes you notice that they are having this umbellate inflorescence. Okay. So that is also one thing that you can notice about. Then the perianth. Flowers are bisexual. They have both andrecium and gynecium. So you should also remember they are trimerous flower, because they have either three or multiples of three, you can notice. So they are trimerous flowers. So they are actinomorphic. That is, you can divide the flower into two equal halves in any plane which passes through the central axis. So they are actinomorphic flowers. So the perianth, here you don't use the terms calyx and corolla because you cannot differentiate between calyx and corolla. Instead, we use the term perianth. Perianth tepals are 6. That is 3 plus 3. Outer whorl of 3 tepals, inner whorl of 3 tepals. And they are often united into tube. So you can see that even in the floral diagram, we have shown that fused condition in onion. So they are often united to form a tube-like structure. So perianth is 3 plus 3. So outer whorl of 3, inner whorl of 3 is there. They are often fused, united to form a tube-like structure. Okay, so the lily flowers, tulips, you can notice this perianth or tepals. Okay, and they exhibit valvate distribution, that is, there is no overlapping nor overlapped condition. So andrecium stamens are 6, but they are in two whorls of 3 plus 3 arrangement. So stamens are 6. Even in onion, you can see the stamens are 3 of them are forming outer whorl and 3 of them are forming inner whorl. So 3 of the stamens are attached to the outer whorl tepals. 3 of them are attached to the inner whorl tepals. So if stamens are attached to tepals, we call it as epiphyllous condition. See, in Solanaceae, we discussed about epipetalous, where stamens are attached to the petals. We call it as epipetalous. If stamens are attached to tepals, we call it as epiphyllous condition. So stamens are 6, 3 plus 3, and epiphyllous in case of onion, you can notice that. Gynecium is, look at the gynecium, they have 3 carpels, 3 locules. So they are tricarpellary, trilocular. So all of them are in threes or in multiples of threes. That is the reason we call the Liliaceae to be trimerous flowers. Majority of monocotyledonous plants are trimerous flowers because the perianth might be 3, stamens might be 3 or 3 plus 3. The ovary might be tricarpellary, trilocular. So this sort of nature you notice in case of monocotyledonous plants. So the gynecium is tricarpellary, syncarpous, they are all fused. Trilocular, ovary is superior, so flower is hypogynous. Okay, trilocular with many ovules. And they have this axile placentation. You can notice this axile placentation. In Solanaceae, what you notice was the placenta was swollen. Okay, whereas here you notice this axile placentation. Fruit is called as capsule. Rarely it is called as berry. Seeds are endospermous. They have this endosperm even after the formation of embryo. So seeds are endospermous. So when you look into the floral formula, so they have bracts, so BR plus within circle indicates it is the actinomorphic condition. Bisexual flowers, you can see this symbol. So perianth, because there is no differentiation between calyx and corolla, then we call it as perianth. They have 3 plus 3 arrangement of tepals, outer whorl 3 tepals, inner whorl 3 tepals are there. So 3 plus 3, they are all fused. So we have put them into brackets. They are all fused to form a tube-like structure, isn't it? So Sugandhraja is also an example of, for where they make garlands of that. Okay, that is also an example of this Liliaceae. So perianth, from andrecium, they have drawn an arrow mark to perianth, which indicates epiphyllous condition. So andrecium has 6 stamens, that is, they are found in 2 whorls, 3 plus 3, and they are attached to the tepals. Epiphyllous condition, you can notice. Gynecium ovary is superior, so dash, the underline should be below, the line should be below G, and they are tricarpellary syncarpous. Since they are fused, we have put them within brackets. And here you can see in the floral formula, so 3 tepals outside, 3 tepals inside, and the outside tepals also, they exhibit valvate aestivation. Inner tepals also, they exhibit valvate aestivation. That is, they are neither overlapping nor overlapped, but all of them are fused. That fused condition we show with this underline or this connecting links are there. So fused condition to form tube-like structure. Okay. So this is what you have to remember regarding the Liliaceae family, the floral formula and floral diagram. So the next is economic importance of Liliaceae family. Ornamental plants, which we grow as shogira, tulips, are example for ornamental plants. Glory also, they also grow it as ornamentals. I told you that leaf apex, if you look at the leaf apex, they have tendrils. Leaf apex has tendrils. They help in climbing. So Gloriosa superba is an Ayurvedic medicinal plant also. Agnipaksha, they call it as. It looks like fire, isn't it? So since the flower is very beautiful, they are not only glorious, but also superb. So they have used this two adjectives to name the scientific name as Gloriosa superba. Okay. Then aloe vera. So commonly noticed, the pulp of which you utilize it for as a for skin care. So as a cosmetic plant, it's a very important plant, aloe vera. Okay, so medicinal plant is aloe vera. Vegetables, asparagus, especially in foreign countries, they use a lot of asparagus. We don't use much. Then colchicine is extracted from colchicine autumnal. See, for cytology, we use this colchicine especially to arrest the cell division stages so that we can study the chromosome structures. So we use this colchicine. Example is colchicum autumnal. So you have to remember all these, whatever given examples in the book, you have to remember the scientific names and their properties. Okay. So that is very, very important. Then I also told you the vegetables, you can also include onion and garlic. They are also members of Liliaceae. So they are also used as vegetables. The most used vegetable is onion. Okay. So that completes our entire topic of morphology of flowering plants. So all these videos which are below, they are all regular class videos. So you can click on them and observe it. So it is a recorded classroom videos that we have. What I have is now PPT presentation videos. These are regular classroom recorded videos. So you can observe them, and also especially Solanaceae, the floral formula and other things. You can utilize these videos to understand them better. Okay. So that completes our syllabus. If you have any doubts or clarification, so kindly let me know so that I can clarify your doubts.